We're looking at a repair job on the Miele model WKR570 WPS. This is the rear of the machine, the lid of the machine, the front of the machine. You can see the various parts there. These are the important tools and parts for this particular repair job. Notice a bicycle pump and the wire from a clothes hanger and a few simple tools such as torque wrenches, electric or manual. This is where the real issues have occurred. We've had some dried out rubberized liquid detergent that has clogged up these rubber hoses. In practical terms, once you can get the rubber hoses out, you can pass something through them, a skewer here or a wire coat hanger, and it helps clear the space. The tricky bits are clearing space through this positive displacement peristaltic pump. You can see it runs in there, goes around, comes out again, and you need somehow to get the clogged liquid out from the space. In this case, I used a thin cable and just poked and prodded until things came out. And then use the bicycle pump to attach to the end here, press and you generate pressure and it clears anything remaining in the pipe. Thank you.
Let's quickly run through the instructions, which are also available separately as a PDF somewhere on this website. To begin with, you're going to need some tools, Torx screwdrivers T20 and 30, bicycle pump and a short length of microbore copper tube for fitting into the flexible hoses, something like a long wire coat hanger that you'd use to poke through the rubber hoses and remove solidified detergent, perhaps a torch or similar light source, a flat screwdriver, and if you do have damaged hoses from Miele, you may need replacement hoses. The first few steps here are about basic items like removing the electrical power from the washing machine, making sure you move it to gain access to the rear, and then using your Torx T20 screwdriver to remove the lower rear panel from the washing machine. The TwinDos system will then be visible on the lower left beneath the washing machine drum. You should familiarize yourself with the mechanical layout that you'll be dealing with here. There's a plastic pipe coming out of the back of the TwinDos container on the right. There's a connection hose, a pair of platinum sensors. There's two different circuits here, one for hoses from container one, one for hoses for container two. Then following the platinum sensors, there'll be a hose running to the rotary pump. The rotary pump itself may well be blocked and you might need to gain access to it. We'll talk about that later. And then you've a hose, I call it hose 3, running from the rotary pump to the front of the washing machine.
At the rear of the machine, we can see a little spigot exiting where the TwinDos containers would be sitting with, you can see a little bit of detergent visible there. That comes out through a small pipe that has been removed, comes up to here. They're nicely color coded so you can see which one is TwinDos 1 and which one is TwinDos 2. You have to remove the circuit board here at the back. It just clips out with these white plastic parts. And then really your issue is how to clear these pipes, which I talk about separately.
The basics of this repair job is that each of the six items above may be, in my case, were blocked by solidified detergent. And then really your solution is to remove one part at a time, clear it and replace it. Before you do that, if we look at step 7, you should remove the TwinDos container, which is possibly already in place, just in case liquid flows when you start taking the pipes off, as it would if you did not have solidified detergent. It's just a good idea to take it out. I use two different handmade parts. One is a length of metal coat hanger, which is nice and stiff and at a twisted shape at the end. It's great for removing dried out detergent from the middle of a small pipe. And sometimes I also used a bicycle pump with a short copper fitting to generate air pressure to blow stuff through the pipes. That was less useful, to be honest. So to begin with, step 10 here, you would, or step 9, sorry, you remove one of the connection hoses, clear it up, replace it. Do the same with the second connection hose. You might need to clear out the middle of the platinum sensor as well, clearing blockages as you go along. You could check if you wish, but in my case, the pump was also blocked, so you're not finished yet. You then need to remove the rotary pump on step 14. To gain access to it, you need to lift a plastic assembly that it's screwed to. That just lifts off when you stretch and undo some clips that you can't see. If you lift it off, rotate it, you gain access to the three screws which you can use to take out the rotary pump. You also need in step 15 to remove the cables and connector attached to the pump so that the pump comes freely away. Step 16 then, you can treat the pump as an item on its own once it's away from the machine. There's a clear plastic lid which you need to clip off. Be careful about this, you don't want to break these flimsy clips. Take careful note of how the system is set up, but really once the clear lid is lifted off, you should be able to prise apart the inner pump hose and a rotary yellow impeller which squeezes the hose in a positive displacement pump. And really you're just clearing everything of any solidified detergent that you see. It's a clear plastic hose, so you should be able to see when it's clear. Then you reassemble, making sure that the yellow impeller is in the right place. There's a little, there's four protuberances that are slightly different shapes, so it'll fit one way only. Be careful to put the ends of the cleared inner pump hose in the right position, and then put everything back as it was, put it back into the plastic assembly. Before you do that, make sure you connect the electrical connector so there's power going to the pump. Feels like you're finished here, but there's just one major step left, which is clearing a long hose running from the back of the machine to the front of the machine. That's step 20. In order to gain access to the front of the machine, you need to remove the lid using two Torx screws hidden underneath plastic caps at the side of the machine. You need to lift off the front instrument panel, maybe free up some cables that are held back with clips. Then take off the front of the machine itself. That can be quite heavy. You need to remove two screws at the latch, a large T30 screw underneath the rubber drum seal, the drum seal itself. You need to use a screwdriver to lever away the spring-loaded door clamp band, and then maneuver the drum seal away from the front of the machine, which would then come away. You've now, at step 24, you've revealed the front of the TwinDos container receptacle, and you can see where two pipes are appearing from the right. You may take off a front section to get better access here. It just clips into place. And then really you're removing the one of the two hoses, the lower one, I believe, from the side of the TwinDos container receptacle and pulling it all the way through from the back of the machine. You might need to move the connection housing, the TwinDos container housing, which is sitting on legs and may well be in your way. And then you've got a nice long piece of hose to clear with the hanger or some other tool like that. And at that stage, you're just reassembling. Doing everything in reverse that we talked about to get to this point. It doesn't take too long. It looks more complicated than it is. Then eventually you have fitted everything back together. You put the TwinDos container containing fluid or water back into the machine, plug the machine in and run through a cleaning TwinDos system cycle. Hopefully this should work this time around. It would not have worked had you had solidified detergent along the way somewhere. Put everything back together. I suspect that it'll take a few washes to start filling all of those pipes that you've emptied with cleaning fluid. So it may take a few washes before this gets back to work normally. But once it's working normally again, you could say thank you very much. Maybe tick the box for a good video. And talk to you about something else some other time. Bye bye. This final section shows the circuit board, which is located behind the TwinDos containers. This can sometimes slip out of place and give rise to problems, such as failure to recognize that the containers are in place. We can see here at the top two little white levers. They get nudged by the TwinDos containers when they're in position. There's a lever here, you can't see it very well, but at the other end of each of these two levers is a small push switch. Connecting to a micro switch telling the circuit board that the TwinDos containers are in the right place. This whole assembly can at times fall out of place and give rise to some odd behavior, but you can easily reach it once you have the back off. Maybe pull it out, take a look, see where it fits, and then push it back into position along two small ridges that it needs to be in to be fitted correctly. You'll feel it click into place, and then hopefully any error messages you are getting will disappear. Thank you.